Yes, no, bless no. We're getting straight back into it. Okay, I had a little breather, but we're going to get back into finishing this record. This is Alice in Chains, Jar of Flies. Not listened to any of it before. You know how we do it over here. So we're going to get stuck in where we left off, and that was on the track No Excuses, okay? Let's see what this tune is saying. I'm enjoying the record so far. Definitely a great standout moment, the last tune we listened to, which was entitled I Stay Away. Brilliant song. Let's get straight into it, people. Oh, and as I dive in, you know who it is. At Des Rocksteady on Instagram or wherever you may please, okay? Contact me, let's get in touch, let's keep things moving, right? One love. King of the Pit TV. What I like about this band is that they're not afraid, well, the guitar isn't afraid to just play nice, broad, open chords. And, you know, some suspensions or whatever you would call it in between, like variation inversions of the open chords. But generally speaking, just nice, broad, easy listening chords and easy listening chord progressions. Really nice. It's the drum pattern is something like I've never heard before. Really good. There's a bunk, bunk, like some percussive sort of bongo of such. I couldn't tell you what it is. I'm not a drummer, but really cool drum. This tune is the drummer's chance to shine, in it really. Wanna take it slow. No more hiding all disguising truths I've sold. Every day is something hits me up so cold. You find me sitting by myself, no excuses. Wow, so that was the chorus section. Let's re-clarify, it's entitled No Excuses. Yes, spot on. The lyrical and the phrasing of the verse and the chorus and so far from what we've heard in this record, just really brilliant songwriting. I'm a big fan of that lead guitar that comes in. I'm also a very big fan of the instrumental in general, purely as it's relatively basic, relatively minimal, just the standard, what I can hear is a four-piece band with a couple of clips in here and there, like for the lead guitar and that, via the studio production and so forth, but it's relatively minimal, and they just do everything they need to do, the instruments they do, they just don't need no flashy nothing, it's just real good roots band music, and I really appreciate that. And when I speak on that, I mean there's no sort of studio wankery as to where they've got all these whoops and whistles going off and all this like crazy technological just nonsense. It's just roots music. Got your strings, you got your drums, and you got a decent frontman doing what he does. Very nice, very nice. You can really pay attention to everything. It's okay. Bassist really creates a fantastic frame around this piece of music. Dum, 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 dum. Or somewhere along the lines of that. It sounds like something from Spyro video game. Catch on to the melody and you can sing the song by the last chorus. Maybe not the lyric, unless you really like latch on to that sort of stuff, but as far as the melody goes, brilliant. They say as far as songwriting goes, you get pulled in by the melody and you stay for the lyric. What can I say? I can't expect much else after this final chorus. The little bridge section there with the guitar solo, so tasty. On this channel, we've been listening to a lot of metal music, and I sort of go over and over that I just cannot stand these guitar solos. But whoever plays guitar in this band, or at least the lead guitar, has a brilliant way around that guitar neck. Absolutely incredible. Fantastic, really good, really good. This record has only got 7 songs on, but this is an absolute powerhouse of a recording. This is so good. These songs are really well written and really resonate with me. I just love the chorus melodies I'm hearing. And in that one in particular, the lead guitar was just very special. The licks that were getting played during the chorus were fantastic, and the actual solo, wow. The drummer, of course, it goes without saying, that drum pattern and the utilization of the, you know, all of the different sections he was playing on, really good. And the bassist just added the whole new incredible depth, you know, really utilized the frequency of the bass guitar there so well. Instrumentally, like I said, the jangling guitars, the bass line, and the eccentric sort of drums that were being hit sounded like something off of Spyro the Dragon instrumental. Yeah, that was really good. Let's move on to this next track, people. So